بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير. In the previous lesson, we discussed about the kinds of al-asma al-mabaniya, the nouns that are fixed, and what is the most important thing, or what is the most a distinguished thing about al-asma al-mabaniya, that they have one form in three, they have one state in three forms, like ja'a Musa, ra'aytu Musa, sallamtu ala Musa. So the ending does not change. So it has three forms, but there is only one state. And today we continue, and today we talk about the علامات الإعرابي الأصلية والفرعية, primary and secondary endings of the nouns, primary and secondary endings of the nouns. So we discussed about this in the very first lesson, and today we see that again. علامات الإعرابي الأصلية في الاسم. So first we talk about the primary endings. Do you remember how many types of nouns have primary endings? Or al-arab al-asliyatu, how many of them?
Three, Ustaz.
Okay, what are those?
One was the usual, the noun which was singular noun, right?
Singular noun and broken plural, only two.
Broken plural and this one, Ustaz, the Jammu, this
Jammu
one.
Jammu Taksir, yes.
Feminine Taksir. Plural.
Yeah, feminine plural. La feminine plural has two endings.
Two endings, okay.
Yeah, so that is not al-asliyatu, that is far'iyatu. So as we can see here, alamat al-irabi al-asliyatu fil ismi, primary endings. So the endings, how do we know the endings? The endings appear with dhamma, wa hiya alamatu raf'i, wal fathu, wa hiya alamatu nasbi, wal kasratu, wa hiya alamatu jarri. As you can see here, primary endings, Dhamma, Fatha, and Kasra, appear only on singular noun, and singular noun both for masculine and for feminine, and also the broken plural. And the broken plural, we know that it is treated as singular feminine. So if we see here, Al-Muslimu, Al-Ismu Al-Mufradu, singular noun, Al-Muslimu, it is Marfu, Al-Muslima, it is Mansub, and al-Muslimi, it is majrur. And similarly, if we have the feminine, it will be al-Muslimatu, al-Muslimata, al-Muslimati. And jamu taksir, the broken plural, al-Kutubu, al-Kutuba, al-Kutubi. So it's very easy to remember that only the singular noun and the broken plural have the primary endings. Only these nouns have the irab al-asliyatu. And the rest of the nouns, their endings are al-far'iyatu, yani they have the secondary endings. So only two types of nouns, singular plural noun, or singular noun, sorry, which is for masculine and feminine both, and the broken plural. وَهُنَاكْ عَلَامَاتٌ أُخْرَى. And there are some other signs, far'iyatun, that are secondary. وَهُنَاكَ عَلَامَاتٌ أُخْرَى فَرْعِيَّةٌ. And there are some secondary endings there. وَهِيَّ فِي الْأَنْوَاءِ الْآتِيَةِ. And these are the following kinds من الأسماعي, from the nouns. As you know that we are discussing with the nouns, so that's why it is only about the nouns. عَلَامَاتٌ أُخْرَى. أُخْرَى is the feminine of? آخر. Akhir, yeah. So yesterday we discussed like akhir means the ending and akhiratu. And when we say al-akhiratu, that means the day of judgment. And here, alamat al-ukhra, there are some other signs, fariyatun, that are secondary. Okay, so what are those? Okay, so we need to know them. The first one is jam'ul mu'annathi as-salimu, which is the sound feminine plural. علامات النصب فيه الكسرة نحو خلق الله السماوات والأرض Okay, so khalaqa, as we know, is the verb, and Allahu ismul jalalah is in the place of the fa'il. As-samawati is maf'ul bihi, and wal-arda is also maf'ul bihi. Okay, now here we can see that instead of as-samawata, it is as-samawati. So that means the sound, the feminine sound plural, when we talk about the nasb, instead of taking fatha, it takes kasra. As we can see over here, خَلَقَ اللَّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ. So, الْجَمْعُ الْمُؤَنِّثِ أَسَالِمُ, this, the ending is فَرْعِيَةٌ, the secondary, and it is not the primary ending. Number two, الْمَمْنُوعُ مِنَ الصَّرْفِ عَلَامَةُ الْجَرِّ فِيهِ الْفَتْحَةُ. So here, the ending of the third form, which is عَلَامَةُ الْجَرِّ, that is also فَرْعِيَةٌ. For example, اِذْهَبْ إِلَى فِرْعَوْنَ. So it's not فِرْعَوْنِ, it is فِرْعَوْنَ. So الْمَمْنُوعُ مِنَ الصَّرْفِ عَلَامَةُ الْجَرِّ is فَتْحَة instead of كَسْرَة. For the feminine sound plural, it is كَسْرَة. For the second, for the نَسْب. And for الْمَمْنُوعُ مِنَ الصَّرْفِ, it will be فِرْعَوْنُ, فِرْعَوْنَ, فِرْعَوْنَ. So the third, which is عَلَامَةُ الْجَرِّ, is فَتْحَة over there instead of كَسْرَة. Number three, al-asma'u al-khamsatu, the five nouns, wahiya, and they are, or these are, abuka, akhuka, hamuka, fuka, and dhu. Okay, dhu does not come with the attached pronouns. So abuka, as you can see here, akhuka, hamuka, or hamuki, it's over here, fuka, and dhu. Kullu al-alamati fiha far'iyatun. All the signs over here are secondary. كل العلامات فيها فرعية. All the signs are secondary. وهي, and these are علامة الرفع الواو. So نحو أجاء أبوك. So when these, one of these كلمات, when it is مرفوع, it will be مرفوع with واو. أجاء أبوك. Did your father come? علامة نصب الألف, and the sign of نصب is Alif, Arifu Abaka, I know your father. And Alamatul Jari Al-Ya'u, Nahu, Aina Sayaratu Abika. So basically, Abi.
Provided it should be in Mudaf, Mudaf ila construction, Ustad, right?
Otherwise, it will not appear. Yeah, it's coming, inshallah, in the next point. Yeah, it should be in Mudaf, Mudaf ila construction, except for Al-Ya Al-Mutakallim. Because when it comes with Al-Ya Al-Mutakallim, then it won't be considered from Al-Asma Al-Khamsa. So here, abuka, akhuka, hamuki, and fuka, and dhu, as we have discussed, it does not come with the attached pronouns. So alamatu raf is waw, and nasb is alif, and jar is ya. And this is what we were talking about. Tu'rabu al-asma'ul khamsatu, the five nouns are declined. Tu'rabu. Are you able to figure out what kind of verb form is this? Is this active or passive?
It's passive.
Passive. Yeah, it's passive.
So present passive, right?
Yes, the present for the mudari. Yes. Turabul asma'ul khamsatu, the five nouns are declined, as we can see in the translation. Bihadhihi al-alamati, by these signs. What are those signs? Waw, alif, and ya. Idha kanat mudafatan, if it is mudaf ila ghayri ya al-mutakallimi. If it is mudaf, other than al-ya al-mutakallim. Yani abu, aba, abi will be considered as waw, as marfu, and or alamat al-raf, and alif as nasb, and ja as jar, if they are mudaf to all the attached pronouns except for al-ya al-mutakallim. Wa illa, and otherwise, illa is basically the combination of in plus la, illa, and it means except. وَإِلَّا أُعْرِبَتْ. أُعْرِبَتْ is also majhul, passive, that we have to learn. أُعْرِبَتْ بِالْعَلَامَاتِ الْأَصْلِيَةِ. Or otherwise, they are declined by the original or by the primary signs. نَحْوُ, for example, لِي أَخُنْ, I have a brother. And what kind of construction is this? Is it a verbal sentence or a nominal sentence?
Nominal
sentence. It starts with jar majrur. So which one is mubtada and which one is khabar?
أخون is مبتدا.
أخون is مبتدا and لي is خبر مقدم. Okay. سألت أخن. I asked a brother. And أنت كأخن. You are like a brother. ك as we know is حرف تشبيه. It is translated as like. Okay. إذا كانت. إذا is a verb. And when it comes, when we use إذا with the past tense, it gives the meaning of the present tense. It gives the meaning of the present tense.
Present tense.
Example from the Quran, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ. Okay, when the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has come, has arrived, and the victory. Okay, so إِذَا كَانَتْ مُضَافَةً. So at this point, we need to remember that after إِذَا, when we have the past tense, it gives the meaning of the present tense. Okay, كَانَتْ refers to what? الأسماء الخمسة. Excellent. تُعرب الأسماء الخمسة بهذه العلامات إذا كانت مضافة. If they are مضاف. And مضافة also is used as feminine because we know that الأسماء الخمسة is the broken plural, so it is treated as singular feminine. Why مضافة is منصوب؟
نعم كان.
خبر
سوري خبر كان.
Yes, excellent. Yeah, كانت, it has both the اسم كان and مضافة is خبر كان. Excellent. Okay, then the fourth one is جمع المذكر السالم, the sound masculine plural. What do you remember about it? أونا, إينا, إينا. Okay, so كل العلامات فيه فرعية. All the signs in this are secondary. وهي and these are علامة الرفع الواو, it is واو. نحو دخل المدرسون, the teachers entered. علامة نصب الياء, and the sign of نصب is ya. نحو سألت المدرسين. So basically ya is the sign of nasb and noon is noon al-irabi. This is the extra noon, and in some cases it gets dropped, and we will see that when it is used as mudaf then it gets dropped. So the sign is basically waw here, alamat al-raf is waw, and alamat al-nasb is ya, and alamat al-jar is also ya as well. هذه غرفة المدرسين. This is the room of the teachers. So una, ina, ina. For jamu al-mudhakkir al-salimi, una, ina, ina. Wow, ya, and ya. Then we have al-muthanna, the dual. Also the same thing here. كل العلامات فيه فرعية. All the signs in it are secondary. وهي and these are علامة الرفع الألف آني أيني أيني. If you remember the sounds, it will be easy for you. So أونا إينا إينا is for the masculine plural, sound masculine plural, and آني أيني 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 is for the dual. So علامة الرفع الألف غاب طالباني. Two students were absent. So آني ألف basically. And علامة نصب الياء, and the sign of نصب is ياء. نحو طالب المدير طالبين. The manager asked for two students. So طالب is the verb, المدير is the فاعل, and طالبين is مفعول به, and علامة النصب is ياء over here. And علامة الجر الياء, and the sign of مجرور is ياء. هذه الغرفة للطالبين. The same thing here. This is the room of for two students. هذه الغرفة للطالبين. This room is for two students. آني أيني أيني. Okay, so five of them we have seen. So do you remember them, all of them? The first one is جمع المؤنث السالم. Okay. آتي آتي آتي. And then we have number two.
ممنوع من الصرف.
ممنوع من الصرف. For example, زينب زينب زينب. اذهب إلى فرعون. Okay, number three.
أسماء الخمسة.
واو ألف ياء, when they are used as مضاف, except for الياء المتكلم. And number four is
جمع مذكر.
Excellent. Sound masculine plural. أونا إينا إينا. And then the fifth one is مثنى. آني أيني أيني. All right. Then we talk about الإعراب التقديري, estimated or hidden ending or declension. Okay, now we have discussed like many times that Ya does not accept or Dhamma or Dhammatain, they are heavier on Ya. So that's why that it gets dropped. But when Ya has Tashdeed on it, then it is okay to for Ya to have Fatha, Dhamma or Kasra. Then it's fine. For example, Al-Kursiyu, Al-Kursiya, Al-Kursiyi, Kursiyun, basically, right? So when it has Tashdeed, then it's okay for Ya to have Dhamma or Fatha or Kasra. But normally, Ya does not like to have Dhamma or Dhammatain, and we have discussed about it many times. لا تظهر علامات الإعراب في ثلاثة أنواع من الأسماء. لا تظهر علامات الإعراب. The endings of the signs of the ending do not appear في ثلاثة أنواع in three kinds من الأسماء in the nouns. فتقدر. Again, this is مجهول. This is passive. فتقدر فيها العلامات. And then so the signs in this are estimated. يعني we estimate them. Or like we try to figure them out. وَهَذِهِ الْأَنْوَاءُ هِيَ And these types are الْمَقْصُورُ the restricted noun, if you remember. وَالْمَنْقُوسُ is the defective noun. And وَالْمُضَافُ إِلَىٰ يَعِ الْمُتَكَلِّمِ And الْمُضَافُ إِلَىٰ يَعِ الْمُتَكَلِّمِ So in the estimated declension or the estimated ending, the signs will not appear. They will be hidden. That's why we call them al-irabu al-taqdiriyu. Taqdir is basically it's from qadr. Laylatul qadr. What's the meaning of laylatul qadr? The night of decree or the night of destiny, right? So this is something that is hidden from us. So from qadr we have qaddara yuqaddiru taqdiran to estimate about something, and that's why it is called estimated irab. Inshallah, I'm sure we will not forget it now. Okay, al-maqsuru. What is maqsur? هو الاسم المعرب it is a declinable noun الذي آخره ألف لازمة and the ending of it is the compulsory ألف الذي آخره ألف لازمة the compulsory ألف يعني it always takes ألف at the end of it okay ألف لازمة why لازمة feminine for ألف all the haruf from alif to ya in the Arabic language, they are feminine. So alif is feminine, ba is feminine, ta, tha, up to ya, all of them are feminine. That's why it is alifun lazimatun, the compulsory alif. Nahu, for example, al-mustashfa, hospital, al-fata, the boy, and al-asa, the stick. So as you can see here, the ending is hidden. It's not appearing over there. For example, we don't have Dhamma over here or Fatha or Kasra over here. That's why it is called Al-Maqsoor. So the only thing that we need to remember that it has compulsory Alif at the end or Alif Maqsoora. As this is called like the Alif Mamduda and this is called Alif Maqsoora, the restricted Alif or the shortened Alif. تُقَدَّرُ فِيهِ الْعَلَامَاتُ وَالثَّلَاثُ نَحْوُ So in it, the three signs are estimated. Again, تقدر is also again passive. فيه العلامات الثلاث. Three signs are estimated in it. نحو, for example, قتل الفتى الأفعى بالأصا. Beautiful sentence. قتل الفتى. The boy killed الأفعى. The snake. بالأصا. By the stick. Okay. So تقول you say في إعراب هذه الكلمات. In the endings or in the declension of these words, al-fata fa'ilun marfu'un, alamatu raf'ihi, dhammatun muqaddaratun. Dhammatun muqaddaratun. So we will say that al-fata is marfu', but the sign of marfu' is dhamma, dhamma muqaddara, yani the hidden dhamma. So the ending is the hidden dhamma. Al-af'a is maf'ulun bihi mansubun, alamatu nasbihi fathatun muqaddaratun, And al-af'a is maf'ul bihi, and the ending sign is the hidden fatha. And then we have al-asa, majrurun bil-ba'i, it is majrur bil-ba, alamatu jarrihi kasratun muqaddaratun, and the ending sign of this is hidden kasra. So all of them, as we can see here, in ism al-maqsoor, the ending will be hidden. Then we have manqus, the defective noun. Huwa al-ismu al-mu'rabu. This is also a declinable noun. Alladhi akhiruhu ya'un lazimatun. And in the end of this, there is a compulsory ya, maksurun ma qablaha. And whatever before it is maksur. Yani, there will be in the end, there will be ya, and before ya, there will be kasra. Nahu, for example, al-qadi, as you can see here in the ending, we have ya, and before ya, what do we have? Ya'un lazimatun.
There
is compulsory ya, maksurun ma qablaha, and whatever before it will be maksur. What's the meaning of maksur over here?
The one which has a kasra, which is the decline.
Excellent. So the one, the noun that has dhamma is called madmum, and the noun that has fatha is called maftuh, and the noun that has kasra is called maksur. Excellent. Similarly, we have al-muhami. What's the meaning of al-muhami?
The judge, is it?
The lawyer.
Lawyer.
Yeah. Al-thani.
The qadi is judge. Is
that? Yeah, this the one? Second. Okay. Yes. Al-madi, the past. And al-wadi, the valley, and al-ma'ani, the meaning. تُقَدَّرُ فِيهِ الضَّمَّةُ وَالْكَسْرَةُ. So in this, we need to remember that تُقَدَّرُ فِيهِ الضَّمَّةُ وَالْكَسْرَةُ. In this, only dhamma and kasra are estimated. وَتَظْهَرُ فِيهِ الْفَتْحَةُ. And fatha appears in it. نَحْوُ, for example, سَأَلَ الْقَاضِي, the judge asked, al-muhami, al-muhamiya.
Because this is maful bihi.
Yeah, maful bihi. So as we have seen that for the marfu and for the majroor, it will be like hidden, but for the mansub, the irab will appear. Sa'al al-qadi al-muhamiya anil jani, about the criminal. The judge asked the lawyer about the criminal. Al-qadi fa'ilun marfu'un alamatu raf'ihi dhammatun muqaddaratun. Also here, alamatu raf' is the hidden dhamma. Al-muhamiya maf'ulun bihi mansubun alamatu nasbihi fathatun zahiratun. Okay, so the fatha is appearing over there, the apparent fatha. And al-jani majrurun bi'an alamatu jarrihi kasratun muqaddaratun. And the sign of jar is the hidden kasra over there. So the difference between maqsoor and manqus is maqsoor will be in the three forms, the ending will be hidden. But for the manqus, for the first form, for the marfu and for the majrur, the ending will be hidden. But for the mansub, the ending will be apparent. It will be apparent. Okay. And the last one is al-ya al-mutakallim. Al-ya al-mutakallim, waqad yakunu al-manqusu mahdhuf al-ya'i. And waqad yakunu, what's the meaning of qad yakunu?
For sure, is it?
Certainly. Qad, when qad is used with the past tense, it means for sure. It means sure. Indeed. Qad aflaha al-mu'minun. Okay. Qad, when qad is used with the mudari, it gives the meaning of maybe, or it gives the meaning of sometimes. And this is min ghayri al-Qur'ani, other than the Quran. In the Quran, when it is used qad with the mudari, or it is used with the past, it will give the meaning of indeed. But in the everyday Arabic, when we use qad with the present tense, it gives the meaning of maybe or sometimes. وَقَدْ يَكُونُ الْمَنْقُوسُ مَحْذُوفُ الْيَاءِ. And sometimes, manqus will be with the drop of the ya, like the ya will be dropped over there. نَحْوُ, for example, ذَهَبَ قَادٍ إِلَى مُحَامٍ. The judge went to the lawyer. So here, as we can see here, the ya has been dropped, and this is what we call mahdhuful ya'i, that sometimes the ya gets dropped. Okay, and we have a note over here. We will see that, like, in which cases ya comes back and in what cases ya gets dropped. Do you remember when ya gets dropped? When it is ismul fa'il for the verb that is naqis. For example, da'a yad'u,
and
da'a
it comes with al, I think it comes back, right?
It comes back in three situations, yeah. So inshallah, okay. We will look at the note. It's just coming. So تقول في إعرابي هاتيني الكلمتيني. هاتيني. هذه. And then we have
هاتاني.
هاتاني. هاتيني. هاتيني. So taqulu, you say, fi irabi, in the ending of. So irabi is mudaf, and hataini al-kalimataini is mudaf ilayh. So in the ending of these two words, you say, qadin fa'ilun marfu'un. Qadin is fa'il marfu. Alamatu raf'ihi dhammatun muqaddaratun. But the sign of raf is hidden. Alal ya'i al-mahdufati, on the ya that has been dropped. So we know that there was a ya over there, and that ya has been dropped, and that ya has been replaced by
a kasra.
Kasratain, which is called at-tanween al-awad, like compensatory tanween. So ya has been dropped, and tanween has been placed with kasratain. Muhammin majrurun bi ila, alamatu jarrihi kasratun. Muhammin is majrur, and alamatu jarri is kasra. Kasratun muqaddaratun, the hidden or the estimated kasra, alal ya'i al mahdufati, on the dropped ya. Al mudafu ila ya'i al mutakallimi, nahu zamili, for example, my colleague. Tuqaddaru fihi al alamatu al thalathu, also in this, all the three forms will be, or the three forms or the endings will be estimated. Nahu, for example, da'a jaddi, da'a invited, jaddi, my grandfather, he invited, yani da'a, he invited, who? Jaddi, my grandfather. My grandfather invited ustadi, my teacher, ma'a zumala'i, with my classmates or with my colleagues. So my grandfather invited my teacher with my classmates or with my colleagues. تقول في إعرابي هذه الكلمات, and in the ending of these words you say, it جدي, basically, as we know that ya is al ya al mutakallim. So جدي فاعل مرفوع علامة رفعه ضمة مقدرة. So also the علامه of رفع is the hidden ضمة. أستاذي مفعول به منصوب علامة نصبه فتحة مقدرة. And زملائي, as we can see here, مضاف إليه مجرور وعلامة جره كسرة مقدرة. So there is another note over here. So there are two notes. The first one was about the like محامن, and the second note is here as well. So this is the note over here, which I have put over here. So note number one, ذهب قاد إلى محامن. It is تثبت يا المنقوس. يا المنقوس is retained في ثلاث حالات, in three situations. Like in three situations, the ya does not get dropped. It is retained. وهي, and these are, أن يكون محلا بالألف واللام, when it is decorated with al. Yeah, al. When it is decorated
alamatu tarif.
Al, yeah, alamatu tarif. Nahu al-qadi. So it was qadin, but when we use al with that, then the ya comes back, so it becomes al-qadi. An yakuna mudafan, and when it is mudaf, when we use it as mudaf, then again ya comes back. Nahu, for example, qadi makkata, the judge of Makkah. So it is mudaf, so ya has come back. And an yakuna mansuban, and when it is mansub, nahu sa'altu qadiyan, I asked the judge, or I asked a judge. Yeah. So in three situations, ya comes back. With al, it comes back. When it is mudaf, it comes back. And when it is mansub, also it comes back. Otherwise, it remains as it is. For example, rahaba qadin ila muhamin. And the second note, as I told you, jara ba'du nahati, some of the like grammarians see, anna hadihi kasratun zahiratun. They say that this kasra is not muqaddara. They say that this kasra is zahira. However, it's not very important. You know, the grammarians, mashallah, they like to know about each and every detail. So we can go with both the ideas. Either we can say that
kasra is muqaddara. I don't understand.
Hidden.
Zumalai, this one is like a jamu taksir, right?
Yeah, zamilun, and you know, like as we discussed, like zumala, it was basically zumala'i, and then ya al-mutakallim has been added to it, so it has been become
okay,
my
yeah,
colleague.
It is ya al-mutakallim. Okay, yeah, this is okay. Got kasra mukaddara. Okay.
Yes, that's right.
It will be mukaddara. Okay.
Yeah, it is mukaddara, but as we have seen the note over here, like some of the grammarians, they say that this is zahira and not muqaddara. Anyways, I mean, that's not something very important.
Only
that's
in that halate jar,
yeah,
ustad, or
yeah, in jar. Yeah. Here, because it is zumala'i, right?
Okay, so because only in halate
The ending of zumala has hamza and there is kasra under that.
Okay.
Zamira, yeah. And the plural is zumala'u. Right? Zumala'u, zumala'a, zumala'i. So that's why some grammarians, they say that this is not muqaddara, this is zahira.
One more doubt, Ustad. Does it mean that in every noun which is in the state of kasra, when it is clubbed with ya'ul mutakallim, then this rule applies or only?
No, only in this case, because the kalima zumala, because this kalima ends with kasra.
Okay.
Only in this case.
Okay.
All right, and there is a summary over here, and al-halatu al-irabiyatu, this is the irabi halat, and then we have al-amilu, the amil, as we have discussed about it, al-ismu dhu alamat al-irab al-asliyati, and then we have these signs over there. So first we discussed about al-marfu, alamat al-raf, so we have to see the alamat al-raf, what is it? Ja'a al-abna.
Ooh.
Ooh, very good. So that's why I didn't, I put this one. So this one doesn't have any endings. So Dhamma, Ja'a al-abna'u, wal-bana,
Stu.
Dhamma, wal-wali,
Dani.
Wal-dani, excellent. So Alif, okay. Wal-aqra,
Buna.
Wow. Wal-aqra, Buna, Aqrabuna, Una. Wa-Ibrahim,
Mu.
Wa akhu, and then we have wa akhuhu. So wow, okay, excellent. So here we have dhamma, here we have dhamma, here we have alif, here we have wow, here we have dhamma, and here we have wow. Now let's look at the mansub. Ra'aytu, I saw.
Abna.
Wal bana.
Tini.
Excellent. Ahsantum. Wal waliday. Okay, and then we talk about the majrur. Sallamtu ala al
abna'i
wal bana
wal banati.
Excellent. Wal walidayni
وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ
وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ
this who, if you remember, we discussed about it, that if there is sakin before it, then it takes kasra.
Yeah.
So in two places it takes kasra, when there is kasra direct before it, like bihi, and when there is ya sakin before
ya preceded with the sukun.
Excellent. So these are the signs of mashallah tabarakallah. So now I'm happy that we are able to recognize all these signs. And then the only thing that is left is al-irabu at-taqdiriyu, the hidden or the estimated endings. So again, al-marfu ja'a
al-sadi hi al-muhammi
والمحامي المصطفى
okay. كل حالتين مقدرة
all of them they have ضمة مقدرة
and كسرة مقدرة
yes and then رأيت صديقي يلا
المحامي
yeah.
put الفتحة yes we have to put فتحة والمصطفى okay so here we have فتحة مقدرة but here we have ظاهرة sorry yeah, here we have فتحة Not fatha, it is, so this is dhamma, right? Not fatha, it should be dhamma, right?
Yes, sister. Dhamma muqaddara. This is kasra muqaddara at the last and only the meaning is fatha.
Al-Mustafa. Okay, and al-majroor we have sadiqi.
Sallamtu ala sadiqi. This is kasra muqaddara, right?
Where? Yeah, kasra. Yeah, it's written over there. Kasra muqaddara, yes.
It is, for me, I am seeing as fatha muqaddara, ustad, in Mustafa, down.
Where kasra muqaddara? Yeah, because over there that is mansub. In mansub, yes.
That's for ra'aytu.
Ra'aytu, because this is ra'aytu.
And it's mansub.
Yeah, all of the nouns, three of them, they are in the state of nasb.
Okay.
They are nasb. Okay, and then the ending one, as we can see over there, We have Sadiqi, Al-Muhami, Al-Mustafa. So all of them, Mustafa. They have Kasra, Muqaddara.
Ustad, I have a question.
Yes, please.
Al-Maqsoor, we cannot say it as Mabni, is it?
No, we cannot. Only the Mabni nouns can be said Mabni. Otherwise, okay. We will say all of them, we will say that this is Marfu and Mansoob and Majroor. And we will say that it is Marfu with Fatha Muqaddara, Dhamma Muqaddara, or Fatha Muqaddara, or Kasra Muqaddara.
Okay.
Yeah, only the Mabni, the nouns that are declinable, only for them we will say that they are. We will not say anything. We will say that this is like in the place of like fatha ala maqami. What do we say that? In the place of like marfu, mansub, and majroor.
Fi mahalli.
Fi mahalli. Ayyuh, that's right. Excellent. Okay. And then we have the summary here as well. Oh my lord. Al alamat al asliyatu wal far'iyatu wal zahiratu wal muqaddaratu. The signs that are the primary and the secondary and the apparent and the hidden. So hadara, attended, al-abna'u, and the sons, wal-banatu, and the daughters, wal-walidani, and the parents, wal-aqrabuna, and the relatives, wa-ibrahimu, and Ibrahim, wa-akhuhu, and his brother, wa-sadiqi, and my friend. Al-Muhami. Why do we have Fatha over there? Shouldn't be over there. Because this is
Marfu. Al-Muhami, this is Dhamma Muqaddara, right?
Yeah, that's right. So it shouldn't be there. So this is typo. And Al-Mustafa. Yes, Mustafa, yes, because it has standing Fatha over there. Okay, Sadiqi. Here we have Al, and here we have Al. But why we don't have Al with Sadiqi?
No, only we
are. It is Mudaf, Mudaf Alayh. Excellent. So when we use with Mudaf, we never use Al. Excellent. And then we have Al Mansub, Da'awtu, I invited Al Abna'a wal Banati. So as you can see here, when it is Mansub, it takes Kasra, wal Walidaini, wal Aqrabina, wa Ibrahima, wa Akhahu, wa Sadiqi, Al Muhamiya. So we know that when it is Mansub, then it will be apparent and Al Mustafa. Ittasaltu, I called, okay, I called bil abna'i. So ittasala bi, it comes with the preposition of bi. Ittasaltu bi abna'i, I called my sons, wal banati, and daughters, wal walidaini, and my parents, wal aqrabina, and my relatives, wa ibrahima, and Ibrahim, wa akhihi, and his brother, wa sadiqi, and my friend, wal muhami, and the lawyer, wal Mustafa, and Mustafa. Okay. Alhamdulillah, we have reached the exercises over there. Ayyin al-Muraba wal-Mabniya fima yati. Ayyin. Yes, please tell me about this. What kind of verb is
Sambaha?
This? Yes, verb form Sambaha. Number two. Yeah. Ayyana yu'ayyinu ta'ayyinan. Okay. Ayyin means to distinguish or to sort out. So
or specify,
out.
Is it?
Specify. Yes, specify. Yes, that's right. Specify declinable and indeclinable. Okay, kitab. So you have to please tell me whether it is morab or mabni. Not declinable morab, and indeclinable.
Kitab.
Okay,
kitab.
Kitab. Kitabun, kitaban, kitabin. It doesn't have al. So yeah, it takes tanween, isn't it?
Yes,
sister. So it is morab. Okay, what about hada?
Mabni.
Haza. Okay.
Hamidun.
Mu'rab. Hamidun. Masajid.
This is
Masajidu,
Masajida, Masajida. Yes, Masajidu, Masajida, Masajida. But is it Mu'rab or Mabni?
Mu'rab.
Okay, huwa?
Mabni.
Mabniyun. Ana?
Ana, Mabni.
Mabni.
Sayyaratun, Mu'rab.
Mu'rab. Excellent. Sayyaratun. Alladhi.
Mabni.
Amsi.
Mabni. Mabni al-Kasr.
Al-Kasr. Excellent. Al-Jamiatu.
Mu'rab.
It's the Mu'rab.
Mu'rab. Okay. Muslimani.
Mu'rab.
Mu'rab.
Muslimani.
Okay.
Muslimat.
Atin. It's
Mu'rab. Muslimatun. Muslimatan. Muslimatin. Muslimatun, Muslimatin, Muslimatin. See? Hadani.
Morab.
Morab.
Hadani,
Hadani, Hadani. Al-Ana.
Mabni.
Mabni.
Okay.
Mabni al-Fat.
Okay. Al-Latani.
Morab.
Morabun. Al-Latani, Al-Latani.
Al-Latani, Al-Latani.
Man.
This is Mabni.
Mabni. Mabni. Okay. Allahu. Ismul Jalala.
Lafzul Jalala is
Morab.
Morab.
Yes. Allahu. Allaha. Allahi. 14.
This is Mabni.
Mabniyun.
Murakkab.
Yes, Murakkab. Okay, what about Arba'a?
Arba'atu, this is
Morab.
Morab.
Morab. Arba'atun, basically. Arba'atun, yeah. Arba'atun, Arba'atun. Arba'atun. And Amina?
Mabni.
Mabniyun. Excellent. All right. Okay, question number 2. Ma alamatul irab al asliyatu fil ismi? What are the primary endings of the noun?
One is jamu taksir and one is ism mufrad.
Now, what are the
alamat?
Alamat.
Alamat. Three alamat.
Fatha, Dhamma, Kasra.
Excellent. Fatha.
Dhamma.
Dhamma, Fatha, and Kasra. Okay. Dhammatu, wal Fathatu, wal Kasratu. Okay. Ma alamatul irab al far'iyatu fi. So, what are the secondary endings in the following groups? Al asma' al khamsati. What are the.
Wow, alif and ya.
Alif and ya.
Excellent. Then we have. Wa and wajam il mudakkari asalimi.
Wow, yeah, yeah.
Wow, yeah.
Wow, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Una, ina, ina. Okay, excellent. Wal muthanna?
Ani, aini, aini.
Alif, yeah,
alif, yeah. Alif, yeah, yeah. Ani, aini, aini. Excellent. Alif, yeah, and yeah. Perfect. Ma alamatul jarri fil mamnu'i min as-sarfi. What is the jar ending in the diptot?
Dhamma, fatha, fatha.
Fatha.
Fatha, okay.
Excellent. Will be dhamma, fatha.
Yeah, Dhamma, Fatha, Fatha. Example, Ibrahimu, Ibrahima,
Ibrahim,
Ibrahim.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala li Muhammadin, kama sallaita ala
Ibrahima.
Excellent.
Wa ala li Ibrahimin.
Yes. Ma alamatu nasbi fi jam'i al-mu'annathi as-salimi?
Alamatu
nasbi.
Kasra. That's Kasra.
You sure?
Kasra instead of Fatha. It's Kasra instead of Fatha.
Yeah, so it is Kasra instead of Fatha. Perfect. Then we have the next one. Okay, it says, Hati mithalan lil maqsuri. Bring, yani, give one example for the maqsur. Waj'alhu fi thalathi jumalin, and then use it in 3 sentences. Ala an yakuna marfuwan, then that you use it as marfu fil ula in the first one. So bring 3 sentences or make 3 sentences. In the first sentence, it has to be marfu wa mansuban fi thaniyah, and it has to be mansub in the second, wa majruran fi thalitha. So basically you have to give the example of al maqsur.
Ja al mustafa,
ja mustafa,
okay.
Ja mustafa, mm-hmm. Ra'aytu mustafa and sallamtu ala
mustafa. Okay, excellent. So here we have kharaj al fata, sami'tu al fata, wa dhahabtu ila al fata. But as you said, Ja'a Musa, Ra'aytu Musa, and Jalastu Ma'a Musa. Excellent. Then we have Hati Mithalan Lil Manqusi, Athabit Al Ya'i. Now you have to give me the example of Manqus noun with Ya being retained. Wa Adkhilhu Fi Thalati Jumalin, and then use it or in 3 sentences. Ala An Yakuna Marfuwan Fil Ula, that it is Marfu in the first part or in the first sentence. Wa mansuban fi thaniya, and it is mansub in the second. Wa majruran fi thalitha, and it is majrur in the third sentence.
Al qadiya, like that.
Ja al thabiti al ya'i. Okay.
Muhami al jaa al muhami.
Okay.
Jaa
al muhami. Al muhami. Okay.
Ra'aytu
al-muhamiya. And marartu bil-muhami. Okay. All right. Excellent. As we can see here, ja' al-qadi, ra'aytu al-qadiya, wa qultu lil-qadi. Like this, you can make, as you have beautifully gave the answers, you can use any of the nouns, and with al, as we know, when we use al, then the ya is retained. Okay. When it is used as mudaf, and when it is
mansub.
Mansub. Excellent. Okay. Now it says hati mithalan lil manqusi al mahdhuf al ya'i. Now you have to give the example of manqus when the ya is dropped. Okay. وَأَدْخِلْهُ فِي ثَلَاثِ جُمَلٍ, and then use it in three sentences. أَلَا أَنْ يَكُونَ مَرْفُوًا فِي الْأُولَى, that it is marfu in the first sentence. وَمَنْسُوبًا فِي الثَّانِيَةَ, فِي الثَّانِيَةِ, sorry. وَمَجْرُورًا فِي الثَّالِثَةِ. Yes. منقوص with محذوف الياء.
مُهَامٍ like that. خَادِن.
Yeah.
ذَهَبَ
قَادِن. Okay.
رَأَيْتُ قَادِن. Without a little.
رَأَيْتُ. When it is منصوب, ya will come back.
Yeah. قَادِن.
Okay. قَادِن. وَجَلَسْتُ مَعَ قَادِن.
جَلَسْتُ مَعَ قَادِن.
قَادِن. Okay. As we can see here, دَخَلَ قَادِن. سَأَلْتُ قَادِن. So we know that when it is منصوب, then the ya comes back. Back and ذهبتُ إلى قادن. I went to the.
So it's like a common noun and using.
Yes. Now هاتي مثالا للمضاف إلى ياء المتكلم. And now you have to give the example of ياء المتكلم. ياء المتكلم, and then we have to repeat the same thing. Okay. So give me the example of ياء المتكلم. هذا أخي.
جاء زملائي.
جاء زملائي.
Okay.
Then
marartu.
Saaltu zumlai.
Zumlai, excellent. Perfect.
Then
jalastu ma zumlai.
Jalastu ma.
Or you can see here, hada zamili. This is my colleague. Raitu zamili and sallamtu ala zamili. So here all of them, the ending will be muqaddara, right? So dhamma muqaddara, fatha muqaddara, and kasra muqaddara. And now, first we will analyze this. Inshallah, this is going to be our last exercise. So I would like you to first complete this sentence. Number 10. By the way, please remember that this is the original book. Only for the first lesson, I'm using the book that has like some vowel signs. And then inshallah, in the rest of the lessons, we will use the books or the book that does not have any signs, like this book. It does not have any signs because now we should be able to, we have reached book number 3, so we should be able to read without the vowel signs by ourselves. Yes, please, quickly.
Arab.
Fill al-amr.
This is a commanding.
Yeah, aslim. You know that.
Adkhil. Ma. Ma. Tahtahu. Khattin.
Ma tahtahu. Khattun.
Khattin, because tahta is an adverb, so this one.
Ma tahtahu khattun. Why? Because ma is.
Mausul.
It's ismul mausul, okay? After mausul, there has to be sila. The sila is either a verbal sentence or a nominal sentence. This is a nominal sentence. Tahtahu, you know that it is dharf wa mudaf alayh. Dharf wa mudaf alayh and jar majroor, they can never ever be mubtada. So this is khabar muqaddam and khattun is mubtada muakhir. The same example, li akhun. The same example. So as we know, as you can see over here, that ma is al-harf al-mawsool or mawsoola. And then tahtahu is mudaf mudaf alayh or dharf mudaf alayh. And this is khabar muqaddam and khattun is mubtada muakhir. You see now, that's why we need to use this book. Okay, yuhibbullahu al-muttaqina. Okay, now please remember that when we say irab, that doesn't mean the vowel signs. That doesn't mean the vowel signs. Basically, we have to tell that whether it is marfu or mansub or majrur. For example, yuhibbullahu,
yuhibbu is
yuhibbu is the verb, fail. Allahu is the fa'il. Wal muttaqina is maf'ul bihi. Excellent. Yes, please. Number 2.
Halakallahu samawati wal arda.
Samawati wal arda maf'ul bihi.
Wal arda. Okay. So as-samawati wal-arda is maful bihi. And we have to only analyze the one that has line under it. Okay, this one, please read it.
Iftah faaka.
Iftah faaka.
Faaka.
Open your mouth. Okay, because this one, the kalima fu, when it is used as mudhaf mudafala, it will be fu, fa, fi. Otherwise, it is used as the regular one. When it is used with the mim, it will be famun, famun, and famin. But when it is used as mudhaf mudafala, then it will be used as fu, fa, fi, the same as dhu, ta, vi, iftah, faka. So faka is maf'ul
bihi.
Okay. Aina sayyaratu?
Abika.
Abika. Yeah. So abika is what?
Mudaf.
Okay. So what is the construction then this one?
Sayyaratu is mudaf and then say abi is mudaf ilayh and then abi is mudaf for
abi is mudaf.
So sayyaratu is mudaf, abi is also mudaf, mudaf and ka is mudaf ilayh. Okay. And what kind of sentence is this? Verbal sentence or nominal sentence?
No, this is a
nominal sentence. Is where is mubtada and where is khabar?
Sayyaratu is mubtada.
Okay, wa abika is khabar?
No.
La?
No, aina is the mubtada, ustad.
Aina is khabar. Sayyaratu abika is mubtada because aina is a dharf. Dharf, how many times we have discussed that dharf and jar majroor cannot be mubtada?
Is it not this thing?
Ismul istifham. It is ismul istifham, but also at the same time it is dharf as well. Because you know aina is used for makan, isn't it? Where? Place. Okay. Hafidhtu?
Suratayn.
Yes, yes. Suratayn. Okay, I memorized two surahs. So suratayn is maful bihi.
Maful bihi.
Okay. Okay, yes.
Arifu Qadiyah Makkata.
Arifu Qadiyah Makkata.
Qadiyah Makkata.
Perfect.
Qadiyah Makkata is mudaf mudafala and maful bihi.
Maful bihi. Arifu, I know. Subject plus verb. Qadiyah Makkata mudaf mudafala. Okay, Qadiyah has fatha. Why Makkah has fatha?
Mamnu min as-sarf.
Mamnu min as-sarf. Excellent. Then we have, yes, number 7. خرج الجرحى
من المستشفى.
Mm-hmm.
First one is a فاعل and مستشفى is
الجرحى.
فاعل.
Is خرج الجرحى فاعل من المستشفى is جار مجرور. Okay. What's the meaning of جرحى?
Surgeon.
لا جريح is the one who is wounded, the person who is injured. And جرحى
the
wounded people plural. Or the injured people. Jarihun and the plural is jarha. Okay. Akhada sadiqi kitabi min haqibati. Akhada
sadiqi is mudaf mudaf
alayhi
and
sadiqi
is
file. Okay, sadiqi is file, the juror.
Where the ma is muqaddara.
Okay, excellent.
Kitabi is mudaf mudaf
alayhi, where again it is
maful bihi.
Yeah.
Okay.
Min haqibati.
Jar majrur.
This is in halatul jar.
Yeah.
Okay. But kasra muqaddara.
Excellent. Akhadha sadiqi kitabi min haqibati. My friend took my book from my bag. Okay. So sadiqi is marfu.
It's a very nice sentence.
And kitabi is mansub.
Okay. Yeah, it's mansub and here it's.
And haqibati is majrur. So fatha muqaddara and dhamma muqaddara, fatha dhamma. Muqaddara and kasra muqaddara.
And kasra muqaddara.
اشتريت هذا بخمسة بخمسة عشر
بخمسة عشر ريالا.
اشتريت I bought هذا this.
هذا. Mm-hmm. Again هذا is مفول به.
مفول به.
And this one بخمسة عشر ريالا. بدل
is بدل.
No, this is B.
جار مجرور.
So this is جار.
جار مجرور.
حالته in محل جر.
مجرور.
It's in the place of جار. Okay.
جار.
So is it? Yeah, so but the ending, as we can see here, does not change.
Compound.
Why? Because it is mabni al fath. And the last one, ana muhamin.
Khabar.
Ana
mubtada.
Ana mubtada muhamin khabar.
Where the ya is deleted, but there should be a dhamma over that.
So both of them are marfu, right?
Marfu.
Ana is marfu. And Muhammad is also marfu. Now, if we go by the signs, if we go by the symbols, we will think that this is majrur. But we are not talking about the signs. We are talking about the irab. And irab means what is the status of the noun, as we have discussed that we say irab means status. So it means whether the noun is marfu or mansub or majrur. Okay, muhamin. Is it?
So it is dhamma mukhaddara against the deleted ya, something like that?
Yeah, the ya has been deleted and it is dhamma mukhaddara, muhamin. Okay, alhamdulillah. So we are closing to complete this lesson, inshallah. It has lots of information, but it's based on everything that we have learned in book number one and book number two. And inshallah, I'm also looking forward to complete this and start lesson number two as well. So inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us learn, understand, and then teach as well. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.